How do I look?
Not as good as me, baby.
Well, fans, here we are for another edition of the bloodiest sport in the galaxy. A tournament where the winners become gods and the losers pay the ultimate price. There they are! Once they were rivals, but now they're one of the fiercest teams around.
That's right. Nothing beats experience, and each one of these three brings loads of it to the table.
Look at Malco. Now there's a guy who can really keep his cool in a firefight.
That's Brock. He's as dangerous to ladies outside the ring as he is to his foes inside.
I love watching Lauren. She's such a little bundle of energy.
Yeah, right. You like watching Lauren for her energy.
Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, previously known as Ultimate Lifeform RB, and allow me to welcome all of you to another new playthrough to begin 2017, featuring Unreal Championship for the original Xbox. This game was originally released in 2002, along with Unreal Tournament 2003 for the PC, which is a sequel to the original Unreal Tournament that came out in 1999. Meanwhile, Unreal Championship, this game is essentially a stripped-down console counterpart for Unreal Tournament 2003, built with the Xbox in mind, and it is my next playthrough to begin the new year, and it is going to be a weekend-exclusive series of uploads. Anyway, we're going to start things off by selecting a new profile, and we have our choice of character. We have a pretty diverse cast of characters here representing different races throughout the Unreal Tournament universe, at least at the time of this game. I'll quickly run down the various races. The Genmokai, these reptilian-esque creatures, have the lowest vitality in general, the lowest health in general among the different races, but they compensate for that by being fast. The same can generally be said for the artificial life forms in terms of being fast and having quick reflexes. You also have various races of humans, like the Anubans, based on ancient Egypt. You also have the Juggernauts, which are gene-boosted humans. These guys are pretty much the opposite of the Gen Mokai. They have higher vitality, but they move slower. And then you have the Mercenaries, which are more or less normal humans. These characters are the all-around characters of Unreal Championship. They don't have any specific weaknesses, but no overall strengths either. And then you have the Nightmare, which includes somewhat mutated and modified humans. And what's interesting about these guys is that as they inflict damage on their enemies, they actually gain health, which is actually, in my opinion, a pretty cool little perk to have. So I'm not going to waste too much time here. I'm going to go ahead and select my character. It's going to be one of the Nightmare, and it's going to be this handsome devil, Brutalis. And one thing you might notice is affinity. Each character has affinity to a particular weapon in this game, which they will always spawn with by default. So Brutalis here is going to have an affinity to the assault rifle. Brutalis. Not my favorite weapon in the game, but we'll go with it. And let's go ahead and enter our name. A nice simple four-letter word, just like I did for the Wind Waker playthrough. And we have our new profile, and we're going to go ahead and dive right into the single player. And we're going to start a new game. So for team name, we're going to go with what I tried to do in Destiny as a fire team, or rather a clan name. Welcome to Fireteam Punk. Enjoy your stay. And we can also select our team symbol. We'll go with the simple gun, and you have four difficulties to select from in Unreal Championship. You have Novice, Skilled, Masterful, and Godlike. We will stick with Skilled, a happy medium here, and we can actually assemble our team because we won't be going it alone in this game. We're actually going to be needing some assistance to get through the many obstacles and challenges we'll be facing in our route to the championship. So I'm actually going to cut out my team selection here, and I will get back to everyone when my team has been assembled. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here I am back with my assembled team, Fireteam Punk, consisting of Demaris, Rapier, Cleopatra, Gorge, and Torch. I've made sure to include as much of the different races as I could within my own team, one from each group. And with that out of the way, let's go ahead and finalize the team. And here we are with the ladder select. There are four ladders initially available. Well, one. But the other three have to be unlocked. And there's also a fifth ladder that we won't see until later on. We have the four possible ladders are Team Deathmatch, Capture the Flag, Domination, and Bombing Run. And initially, all you have is Team Deathmatch. And we are going to start with Fireteam Punk versus Hellspawn in a 1v1. And the map is going to be Insidious Team Deathmatch, 10 minutes, and the first to 10 points wins the match. So here we go, folks, our first bit of Unreal Championship action, and it should be exciting. So here we go. Press fire to begin, and let's go ahead and get underway. The objective of Team Deathmatch is for your team to score more total kills than your opponent. I'm going to go ahead and turn off the hints so I can keep things running here, and yep, that's basically it. Although, essentially, since it's a 1v1, this is more of a regular deathmatch than anything else. Now, you can see the Nightmare character's ability in action here. As you notice, my health started rather low, only 70 points, but as I was doing damage to my opponent right there, my health was actually increasing. I kind of like that little perk with the Nightmare characters. Now, the health boost only goes to a certain point. Once you reach a certain health value, you won't gain any more, but still, that's a pretty cool trick to go with. So let's go ahead and take out Siren here. Siren here is a Juggernaut, which means she's going to have more health than me at the start, but she's also a bit slower, which is going to make her a little bit of an easier target. And now I'll go into a little bit of the background of this game. the story of Unreal Tournament usually is, basically it's a form of legalized murder in terms of the tournaments and stuff, and it's meant to be like sort of a blood sport. That's actually not the plot line here in Unreal Championship. Unreal Championship sort of takes place in an alternate universe where the tournament is still around, but it serves a different purpose. In the universe of Unreal Championship, there's actually a powerful alien empire has conquered much of known space, and basically anyone who disobeys the empire or tries to go against them is forced into the tournament as punishment. So all these people that we're fighting as and fighting against in the tournament have all gone against this empire, and this is their punishment, to be forced to literally fight for their lives. Interesting, I suppose. You know, a little bit different than just being, here's a tournament, now fight in it. Although it's not that much better than that, it does have a little bit more justification. So right now I'm using a gun called the Flak Cannon, which is actually one of my favorite Unreal Tournament slash Unreal Championship weapons. And you also have the Rocket Launcher, the Shield Gun, which I'm not really going to use very often, Assault Rifle, and that's about all I've got in my arsenal. Some of the usual pickups in Unreal Tournament are back for this game. We have the Shield pickup, which gives you a little extra protection before you start losing health. There are also health pickups and a couple other power-ups we'll see a little bit later on. And we are 7 kills away from the score limit of 10. Let's see if we can complete the shot out here. Although it is only on skilled, it shouldn't be that much of an issue. Now, like the original Unreal Tournament, every weapon has its own primary fire and alternate firing mode. For instance, here with the rocket launcher, primary fire is a single rocket, but if you charge up the alt fire, you can launch up to 3 rockets in a cluster at once, which if all 3 rockets hit, it's pretty much a guaranteed kill no matter how much health the opponent has, and if it doesn't kill them, it will leave them hurting. Now if we drop down, we can get another classic weapon, the minigun. The minigun has 2 firing modes, of course. One fires faster, the other fires slower. And the flak cannon has this as its primary shot, and it also has the flak grenade as its secondary shot. Like, a lot of the weapons are pretty much the same from their classic Unreal Tournament counterparts. It's just like the designs are a little bit different and such, but for the most part, if it functions a particular way in the original Unreal, it pretty much functions the same way in Unreal Championship slash Unreal Tournament 2003. Now you may notice another counter that's on the top right of the screen. That is your adrenaline counter. The adrenaline counter, or rather the item adrenaline, was introduced in this game as well as Unreal Tournament 2003. Probably won't get to explain it for this match, so I'm actually going to go ahead and see if I can finish off Siren here. We've kind of dicked around a little too long for this first match, although it is a 1v1. 1v1s tend to be a bit of a slower pace, although since this map is a bit small, our opponent doesn't have very many places to hide. Aha! Got her! Alright, so that is our first match of the playthrough. Managed to get 10 kills in just under 5 minutes, and it's a 10-0 shutout for Fireteam Punk. An excellent start in our quest through Unreal Championship. But we are only just getting started with our first tournament ladder, the Team Deathmatch Ladder. And our next match is going to be Fireteam Punk versus Firestorm in a 2v2 matchup, myself and Damaris, and the match will take place on Molten. It's a 10-minute time limit, and the first team to score 20 points will be the victor. So now we have the extra dimension of teammates actually being added to the equation. Let's see how this match goes. And right away at that startup screen, we saw another power-up that frequently makes an appearance throughout this game. The double damage power-up. This power-up returns from the original Unreal Tournament, and if you can pick up the double damage power-up, for 30 seconds, your weapon will do double damage. It's pretty self-explanatory, but right now, I need to move double time, because right now, my team is currently down 2-1. Haven't even come across an opponent yet. I'm sure they will make their appearance very shortly. In fact, there they are! And we have one using the rocket launcher. Need to be careful with that. And we're gonna have to move it here. What the heck is going on here?
You be dead.
And my teammate comes in and gets the tying kill. Now let's go ahead and go on a run here. So as you can see, that's one thing that having additional players on each team has added. The other team has actually put up a couple points here initially. They actually had a good lead. Well, not a good lead, but they had a 2-0 lead at the start, which is now a 7-3 deficit. And right now I am using a gun known as the Link Gun. The Link Gun fires these energy shots in its primary fire, but in its secondary fire, if you hold down the left trigger, it will basically produce this stream of energy. And I believe my teammate actually got the double damage power up, which did a good job of softening up Scarab there for a quick kill. Now I'll go ahead and talk about the adrenaline. The adrenaline, as I said earlier, was introduced in this game and Unreal Tournament 2003. And essentially, it serves as kind of an ability booster. If you collect a full set of 100 adrenaline pills, you will be able to unlock several abilities that, when triggered, will do things like boost your health, boost your speed, boost your weapon firing rate. I'll go ahead and activate one right now. I went ahead and activated Booster, which in Unreal Champ, which in Unreal Tournament, well, in this game is called it's called Regeneration, but in Unreal Tournament 2003, it's called Booster, but it's the same purpose regardless of the name. It will regenerate your health, and it will also give you shields up to the maximum capacity of 150 shield points. Now, to activate an adrenaline combo, you need to input certain directions on either the analog stick, the left analog stick, or the D-pad, and I'll actually post a graphic in post-production that will show off the different adrenaline combos that you can activate. To activate regeneration like I did, simply press backward on the D-pad or the analog stick 4 times. And look at that dominating victory, 20 kills to 5. I got 14, Damaris contributed with 6, and Feralith was the only one that got any points for the blue team. 6, Scarab got nothing. During the match, you can check the scoreboard by pressing the black button, and you can also check individual stats by pressing the white button. So I got 13 kills with the Link Gun, 1 kill with the Flak Cannon, no deaths, no suicides, and I had 100% efficiency in a match playtime that took 3 minutes and 2 seconds. We can also look at Scarab, who got no kills. Damaris, who actually did rather well. And I think that's going to round out this first match. Gonna do maybe one more match, keep this first episode relatively short. One or two more, depends on how things go. I'm generally going to be doing, there are 7 matches per ladder, so, and since this is going to be a weekend upload, that's going to be, you know, 2 videos a weekend, I'm going to see if I can devote 1 weekend each to each of the ladders, so probably about 4 or 5 weekends. So this playthrough might not take that long to do if everything goes right. Although I should point out right now, I am playing this on an actual Xbox with an actual copy of Unreal Championship, and unfortunately, this old Xbox is showing its age. It's having disc read problems and stuff, but oddly, it's mostly avoided it with this game. I'm not quite sure what's going on. Anyway, we actually now unlock the Capture the Flag ladder. However, we're going to maintain our focus on the Deathmatch ladder, and our next match is going to be Fireteam Punk versus the Rock Pounders in another 2v2 contest. And this map is going to be Vedona, 10-minute time limit, 20 points. Let's go ahead and dive into the action. Now, I'll go ahead and talk about my history a little bit with this game. My memory isn't the best, but I believe this is actually the first Unreal Tournament series game I actually played. I know that the first Unreal game was a single-player game, like an adventure game, FPS, but I think this was actually the first Unreal series game I ever played, this game for the Xbox. Although, around the same time, I actually did get Unreal Tournament 2003 as well. I didn't actually play the original Unreal Tournament until I played the PlayStation 2 port, which unfortunately is a bastardization of the original game, I'm not gonna lie. And I'm saying that as someone who played the PlayStation 2 port of Unreal Tournament for a playthrough back in 2013. I have quite a bit of nostalgia for this game. I mean, I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. This game is nowhere near the PC games, obviously. And I'm saying that as someone who is not a PC gamer, so I don't have that inherent bias. But I can recognize when a particular version of one game is not as, you know, is not as good as another version. And this really is a stripped down port. Like, the PC games have more features, you know, the graphics are better, frame rate is better and stuff. Although that also depends on your PC in general. And these guys are starting to make a comeback. I'm getting a bit sloppy here, because one of them's armed with a rocket, the other one is armed with a flak cannon. That's a nasty combo. But I'm able to take both of them out with the assault rifle, a gun that I typically don't use. If I spawn with something like the assault rifle, I'm going to find another gun as quickly as possible. But right there, I managed to clean house. Let's go, Damaris. Although you're not looking so good right now, buddy. You're at 37% health. And again, the Gem Makai do not have a high health pool as it is. So you need to be careful with them. Go ahead and get the shield pack. Now, where was I earlier? Oh yes, I went on a tangent about my history with the Unreal series. This is basically where I started this game in Unreal Tournament 2003. And I have quite a bit of nostalgia for this game, mostly in local multiplayer and stuff. I did have the original Xbox Live service when this game came out and when I got this game, but I think I only played one round, and I don't remember it running all that well on Xbox Live. But then again, it was a very long time ago, and I can't go back and show that off now, because the original Xbox Live service for original Xbox games ended in 2010. They actually cut it off. You can no longer play the official Xbox Live for original Xbox games, which is kind of sad, but, you know, they had to do it eventually. Like, most of my memories come from, you know, spending hours playing this game with my cousins. We'd go against the AI, and we would just own the AI. Sometimes we'd go against each other. It was a lot of fun back in the day. Especially some of the game types we're going to be seeing later on beyond just Team Deathmatch. But these guys are trying to put up a fight, and he got caught! Or she, I think that was a female. That's one of the female characters. She actually got caught in part of the level trying to, I guess, jump across. And she's back for more, but my rocket will outdo hers. And I'll go ahead and unveil another adrenaline combo as we end the match. Now, the Berserk combo actually increases, I believe, the firing rate for your weapons, although we didn't get to really demonstrate that, as the match came to a very decisive end. 20 kills to 9. They put up a little bit more of a fight, and I actually died a couple of times. They actually killed me twice. So no, I am not invincible, but it's all well and good. Damaris contributing to the cause with 9 points of his own. And that's going to end this match. And I think that is going to mark a good cutoff point for this first episode of this playthrough. I would do another match, but I think I'll save the next four or so matches for the next episode, since, you know, for this video I had to do the intros and all that other stuff in addition to the matches I initially did. So, with three matches down, four to go in the deathmatch ladder, we are going to stop here. That is a wrap on this first episode of the Unreal Championship playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw here, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. Hopefully you'll stick around, as this is actually a game I've wanted to do for quite a while. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now, and I will see all of you in the next episode!